Let's move on to gamma to see how that variable works in relation to the price of the of our entire portfolio and individual positions. Gamma is the measure of the change of an options delta with respect to a 1-point move in the underlying stock or ETF or future. So in other words, gamma itself is not a variable on directly on the price of the option, but rather gamma is the measure of the change in the delta. So it has more of an effect on the delta than it does on the, directly on the price of the option itself. When buying an option, gamma is positive. When selling an option, gamma is negative, regardless of whether it's a call or a put. This often confuses people because you have to keep in mind that gamma is the measurement of the rate of change of the delta, not of the option. In practical terms, a positive gamma is something that you want if you believe the market is going to be making a large move. If you are positive gamma, it will affect the delta in a way that will increase the price of the option if a large move is coming in the market. Long puts and calls are long gamma, and you make more money when the market moves. If you're short calls and puts, on the other hand, you're short gamma, and that means that you do not want the market to move too much. In our case, almost all of our positions are short gamma. We don't mind if our positions move, but not by too much. Normally, when you're short gamma, that means you're selling calls and you're selling puts. So when you have a short gamma overall position, you are also going to be long theta. And theta is where most of the money is made. So let's move on to theta. The types of positions that we put on are all positive theta positions. Theta is the measure of how much an option loses value on a daily basis as time approaches expiration. Theta increases in size as it nears expiration. What this means is that the closer to expiration an option is, the quicker it loses its value. That's why I've mentioned in other videos that theta will increase as we get closer to expiration. In our case, we are positive theta on our diamond position of $6.06. That means that we should collect $6.15 every single day that we hold this position until expiration, as long as price remains within a certain range. On our EEM position, we are positive theta or long theta $9.47. That means on average we should collect $9.47 every single day that the EEM remains within a certain price range. On the IWM position, we are long $9.96 or close to $10 in theta. We are positive theta by $10 on a daily basis. In other words, if price remains constant and doesn't dramatically change or go outside of our the parameters that we want it to go out of, we will collect an average of $10 on that position alone per day. Our SPY position is also positive theta of about $10.40. As long as the price remains within a given range, we will collect an average of $10.28 per day for every day that we hold this position. These variables, of course, change constantly.